In South America, you can buy avocados on every corner and find them in almost every dish. If we travel back in time, even the Incas ate avocados. As well as being one of the main ingredients in South American cuisine, the fruit now also gets a lot of love and attention in the rest of the world. Nowadays, avocados are a popular ingredient in loads of dishes. What's not to love about avocado? But where does the avocado come from? We, as Nature's Pride, supplier of avocados in Europe, want to take you on a trip across our main supplying countries and growers in Mexico, Chile, Peru, and South Africa. It all begins with planting a small tree. After growing the small tree, the plant is crafted with the Hass variety. Then the tree can grow out to a large avocado tree. This process takes place in a nursery. Our grower in Chile has the biggest nursery in the world. When the avocado tree is strong enough, it will be planted in the soil. These areas are, for example, rocky mountains or fields that were used to grow other crops such as corn and pines. In certain Mexican areas, deforestation is an issue, which means vegetation is cut to plant avocado trees. But how do we cope with deforestation?
We would love to end deforestation 100%. Is it possible? I hope so. We can only do our part by not participating in it, by working with the same growers, by not working with people we don't know. We can do our part as a company to supply our best avocados from the best growers to our best customers like Nature's Pride, somebody that demands that we do things right from farm to table.
By using smart water techniques, water is used in the most efficient way. But how are our growers managing their water supply? In South Africa and Mexico, 90% of the water comes from rain.
We have more water than what we use. In our area, the rainfall is 1,200 to 2,000 millimeters, and there's generally more water going out of the area than coming into the area.
In northern Peru, the water comes from the Andes. This water is supplied to the population and is used to irrigate the trees.
Y esa agua nosotros nos abastecemos del reservorio del Gallito Ciego, que viene de diferentes canales, ¿no? Se almacena junto con el agua de las lluvias, luego la transportamos hasta aquí para poder almacenar todo eso y poder abastecernos en nuestros cultivos.
In Chile, we pump the water from an underground water lake called an aquifer.
Water is very important for us. We get it from an aquifer. First, it snows, and when that snow melts, we pump it from the underground aquifer where the water gets. Then we get it up the mountains, and then we use drip irrigation technologies to put only the amount of water that each tree needs. We have an agronomist who calculates how much water each tree needs, and he does it by digging some holes in the ground and making sure that the soil has the specific humidity content that it needs. He also checks how much it has rained and how much water has been evaporated. And then with all that information, he can determine how much water to apply to each tree.
Additionally, our growers are the most innovative in other soil techniques. For example, making their own compost.
Hacemos lo que es el subsolado. Entran máquinas a nuestros campos para poder dar vuelta a lo que es el suelo. Se incorporan materias orgánicas como el compost para enriquecer el suelo y poder tener mejores paltas y mejor rendimiento también.
Back to growing an avocado tree. The tree needs to flower first before growing avocados. For a sustainable way of pollinating the flowers, we use bees. Within a few months, tiny avocados will grow out to mature avocados, ready to be harvested. Our avocados are harvested with a higher dry matter and oil content. This means that the picking seasons start later, which results in a creamier and nuttier taste. The harvesting methods differ per country. In Mexico, many farms have big and tall trees. In Chile, the trees are high-density planted, and in South Africa, it's a combination of both. The harvest of avocados provides the employees of the farm a stable and year-round salary. Our growers provide, for example, farm housing, bus transportation when they live in nearby villages, access to medical clinics, primary schools, educational materials, and sport facilities.
Een duurzame avocado is alles voor ons. Het is heel erg belangrijk dat de teler het goed heeft, de mensen die bij de telers werken het goed hebben en dat er gezorgd wordt voor het milieu. Wij borgen dit met sociale certificeringen die de telers moeten volbrengen.
Our avocado growers undergo a yearly social audit, which analyzes working conditions, such as working hours, safety and care for the environment, such as deforestation and the use of pesticides. After harvesting the avocados, they are transported to the packing house, where the avocados get an extensive quality check, are washed, sorted, checked on size, labeled, and packed for transport to Nature's Pride. After 3 weeks on the boat, the avocados arrive at Nature's Pride, and first things first, an extensive quality check is carried out. Then the avocados go straight to the ripening area.
De beste kwaliteit garanderen wij door continu de seizoenen van de verschillende landen te monitoren. Als het seizoen eerder afloopt, zullen we eerder schakelen naar een ander seizoen. En als de kwaliteit niet toereikend meer is, zullen we ook eerder schakelen naar andere landen. Zo ontzorgen wij de klant en garanderen wij de kwaliteit.
Our ripening masters are fully trained and educated. It's all about understanding the avocado. Every avocado has its own story. They come from different areas, growers and climates. Therefore, every avocado is in need of its own process and can't be treated the same way. We know exactly what each avocado, from wherever in the world, needs to get perfectly ripened.
We simuleren eigenlijk het land van herkomst door middel van temperatuur en door middel van relatieve vochtigheid. Daarbij is het altijd van belang hoe reageert het fruit op die omstandigheden. En daaraan passen we ons rijproces aan.
The avocados are ripened from the inside to the outside. And ripeness is measured by pressure. Color doesn't influence the ripeness. After 5 days in the ripening rooms, the avocados can make their final steps to the consumer. Mechanical sensors determine the pressure, exterior and interior of the fruit. Only the highest quality and perfectly ripe avocados will receive their purple Eat Me sticker.
We hebben de lekkerste avocados omdat de teler de perfecte droge massa en de oliegehalte oogst. Want wij het rijproces helemaal onder de knie hebben, zodat de klant een perfecte avocado heeft.
This full process results in perfectly ready-to-eat avocados that fully connect with the needs of the consumer.